Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. So today, what we're gonna do is we are going to talk about fat loss. I'm sure the question everyone wants to know the answer to is, what is the best way to burn body fat? Or what do you need to do in order to burn fat? The thing is that these days there are countless of different diets and training programs that all claim to help us burn fat. However, because there is so much information out there, I think it's very easy for someone to get confused as to what works and what doesn't. Well, I'm here to tell you that if your goal is to lose body fat, then all you need is something that you already have. It's your body. Your body is actually an expert at burning fat. Because that's what it does for a living, literally. Your body's job is to keep you alive, and it does that by burning fat. So to help you understand this better, I'm going to give you a short lesson in anatomy and physiology. I'll do my best to keep it fun and easy to understand. So please stay with me because this is information that I think you really need to know, especially if you want to lose weight and burn fat. So let's get to it. So our body needs energy to function, and we use food as energy. When we eat food, our body converts that food into glucose. Glucose is the primary food for our cells. That includes our brain cells, muscle cells, and heart cells. However, glucose cannot get into the cells without a little bit of help. So when glucose is present in the bloodstream, the pancreas secretes a hormone called insulin. Insulin opens the door to our cells so that glucose can enter. Once inside, glucose then gets stored as glycogen. When our cells get enough food, the excess glucose gets stored in our fat cells as free fatty acids. Insulin then closes the door to our cells and slowly leaves the body. When our body needs energy and there's no food around, then our fat cells release the free fatty acids for the body to use as energy. And that is how our body burns fat. However, the body can only access the free fatty acids when insulin is not around. And the thing about insulin is that it comes into our bloodstream really fast, but it takes a while for it to go away. Kind of like how it's easy and fast to catch a cold, but it takes longer to get over the sickness. So if we're constantly eating throughout the day, and every time we eat, insulin is present, then our body is always in fat storing mode and rarely in fat burning mode. This is why intermittent fasting is so popular for weight loss, because it reduces your eating window, which allows more time for your body to burn fat. Now let's go over the key points. Number one, our body has two storage forms of energy, glycogen and free fatty acids. Number two, insulin is a hormone that controls fat storage and prevents fat burning. To simplify it even further, I like to think of it this way. Glycogen is the food that we store on our kitchen counter. It's readily available and easy to access. Free fatty acids is the food that we store in our pantry when we run out of counter space. Insulin is the food police. It tells us where to store our food, and it also prevents us from getting into the pantry to get more food. So let's say you ate all of the food on the kitchen counter for breakfast, and then you get hungry again, but you can't get into your pantry to get more food because the food police hasn't left yet. He's still guarding. As I mentioned earlier, it takes a while for insulin to leave our bloodstream. So to get rid of your hunger, you most likely are going to drive to the supermarket to grab more food. But the problem is when you bring the food home from the supermarket, the food police shows up again and then tells you to store some of your food on your counter and then the rest inside your pantry. And remember, you can only access the food inside the pantry when the food police is not around. So if this process keeps repeating itself, you would keep running to the grocery store to get more food while your pantry keeps getting fuller and fuller. And that's pretty much how we gain weight. we tend to store more fat and we rarely burn any. So in conclusion, if we want to help our body burn fat, then we need to focus on controlling insulin. How do we do this? Eat less often. Because as long as insulin is present, your body cannot burn fat. So by shortening your eating window, you are giving your body more time or the opportunity to burn fat. If you're interested in learning more about insulin, then check out the link below. It's for a book called The Obesity Code, which was written by Dr. Jason Fung. And in his book, he goes into a lot more details on insulin and how to burn fat. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more videos like this. I hope you enjoyed my explanation of how to burn fat. And if you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comment section below. Until next time, do your body a favor and stay away from the food police. Bye guys!